After a 0-0 draw in the first leg of the Champions League quarterfinals, it's Manchester City at home to start us off today. We then follow up with a cup final in the Copa del Rey. We've reached a domestic cup final in every season of this save, but we haven't won a domestic cup final in every season of this save. But hopefully we can make it 3 from 4. If we're able to win the Copa del Rey against Villarreal later in the episode, we'll sim Osasuna and then we'll play Barcelona away from home in La Liga as we continue to try and close the gap on themselves and Real Madrid at the top. The gap continues to get smaller bit by bit, and it really is bit by bit, but slowly but surely we're reeling them in. We could be a lot closer if we'd beaten them yesterday, but hopefully we can still get the job done. We're going to have to start by getting this job done, though. One game, one competition at a time. Champions League, Copa del Rey, La Liga. Let's start with Manchester City. Drop the video a like if you enjoy, of course. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel so you don't miss out on more. And, of course, the new RTG series when it starts in a few days' time when next-gen FIFA 21 is available on the new consoles. But fingers crossed, we can go through here. We kind of need a win in 90 minutes, though, to ensure that if City score, the only result we can get is in 90 minutes. The only way we can go to extra time is via a 0-0. And I don't want a 0-0. I want a win. So let's go and do it. Manchester City line up against a slightly different to before. Only change being that João Cancelo is out of the starting lineup and Nelson Semedo is in on the right-hand side. Harry Maguire starts alongside Aymeric Laporte. That's a change for them as well. Of course, our Ferran Torres used to play for Manchester City in real life. I mentioned that in the last game. One thing I didn't actually acknowledge was that, of course, we've signed Antoine Griezmann back here as a former Atleti player, but he came in this save from Manchester City, not from Barcelona. So, two players in our starting lineup playing against their former team in the shape of City. A 0-0 draw from the first leg, looking to get ourselves through to the semi-finals of the Champions League if we can. One English side brushed aside in Tottenham, the next in our sights in Manchester City. Hopefully, we can face someone different in the next round, although I wouldn't mind facing Everton at some point, although they're 3-0 down from the first leg against Paris Saint-Germain, so it would take one hell of a turnaround back at Goodison Park for us to face a third English side in the Champions League this year. I hope they can do it, though. Correa. Oh, the defender came towards me there, actually wiped the man out. Koke coming forward, plays it forward to Youssef Fatal from right back. The angle is tight, and he does not have the ability to shoot, evidently. My word, what a terrible strike from Youssef Fatal. Oh, dearie me. I did think we could use him as a right winger on occasion when needs be. And we still could, but certainly I will avoid shooting with him for the rest of the save. Because if that's all he can muster, it's not worth it. Can't quite get there. Here's Nelson Semedo. Back to Maguire. Forward to Phil Foden again. Koke going to have to drop back and get involved defensively here. Jesus to Phil Foden. Excellent footwork from the young Englishman, but not able to get away from the defender right. Oh, I was going to try and play the man in down the left, but they've won it back here. Reynan Lodi steps in, but still the danger is here for City. And they score the away goal. Bernardo Silva just sent me to the shops there. The fake shot. And in comes the defender, sliding through. I mean, you expect him to shoot there. Absolutely sent me. Thrown to the floor there, Konate, and thumped home by Bernardo Silva. City have their 1-0 lead. They have their away goal. We need two in the next 75 minutes or so. In fact, the next 65 minutes or so. Otherwise, we will be out of the Champions League. Their away goal gives them effectively a two-goal advantage here, Manchester City. And we really do have a challenge on our hands now. Nice tackle by Konate. Back kill to Koke. Here's in Antoine Griezmann. Oh, Llorente battling hard with Phil Foden, but coming off second best. Issa Maouar could send Newton in down the left, but he's turned back central, and he still has options. And there's Gabby Jesus in an acre of space between the lines, and Raheem Sterling could go either way. Lovely turn, Jesus in, and it's 2-0 City. They were good in the first leg. They are even better in the second. We had to fight hard to keep ourselves level in that game, but the footwork here from Sterling is again outrageous. They've been too good with the ball at their feet, City, Bernardo Silva and Raheem Sterling, making a mockery of my defence. Jesus found so much space between the lines there. He dropped deep from his striking role, but still so much room. So much room for him in the gap. But room here for Griezmann, and we could pull it back. We have pulled it back to 2-1. It's not done and dusted yet. Oh, hello. Smacking it against the post. Careful not to do a Michi Batshuayi from the World Cup. All right, maybe it's not over yet then. At half-time in the other game, Everton are trying their hardest to turn it around. It's 2-1 there. If they make it 4-1, they'd still go out on away goals. So they do need to win 5-1, Everton. So they're trying their hardest, but it doesn't look like it's going to be successful for Everton to get through to the semi-finals of the Champions League. And on the first half's evidence, it doesn't look like we're going to get ourselves through either. We need a turnaround of sorts here too. Everton need another 3. We need another 2. And it could well be away goals that see us both go out. My club and my former club might well be falling at the same hurdle. We've 40 minutes left to turn this back round in our favour and get Atletico Madrid into the semi-finals of the Champions League. The ball just keeps falling for City at the minute. It's Phil Foden. Again, it could be good footwork that works for City here. I tried to play that forward to the striker, actually. And it went out towards Ferran Torres. Koke fighting hard. Bernardo Silva trying to find some space for cross. Renan Lodi does well, but it'll be... Oh, actually, our throw. That's rather fortunate. There's still enough time. Oh, no, Jose! Fouled, and that's why he wasn't able to keep the ball. Foden off, and... Actually, don't know who that is. Is that... Martin Odegaard? Or did he go to Manchester United in this save? I can't recall. I certainly don't recognise the... it's Palaversa for Phil Foden. I'm not sure if that's... The substitution they need right now, City, to hold on to this lead. This lead that might be leaving them. Oh, if only we could pass. Oh, my God. I won't get a better opportunity. I'm certain of it. Two people there to play the pass to. What looked like an easy ball. And he's kicked it straight to the defender. Unreal. That should be 2-2 with us having half an hour to try and find one goal to win it and go through. Still, we need 2 goals to go through. Joao Felix out looking for Correa. He'll find Griezmann. Here's Felix. Oh, and again, it's the passing that lets us down. It's just not quite good enough. I don't know what change to make to try and change things in my favour either. I might move Llorente to that role and bring Quincy Promes on. We're going for it here. But we have to. It's 2-1 City still. That's a big ping. We should win this with Atal though. And have done. Inside with Correa to Griezmann. Support arriving from Quincy Promise. Looking for the run. It was Joao Felix. Get it onto that right foot. And we're back level on the night with 7 minutes to try and win it. As it stands, City still going through on away goals. But there is time. There is time. But not much of it. Casemiro lifts that over the top to Palaversa. Semedo. Lifted that nicely into the path of Riyad Mahrez, who's come on for Bernardo Silva here on the right-hand side of their attack. He just needs to waste some time, and he's doing that very well. Semedo kicks that straight against Ferran Torres, but he'll let it go out for a throw, and time is ticking away from us here. Semedo needs to just waste some extra seconds. Come on, Renan, win that. 2 minutes added on. Nelson Semedo's doing exactly what his City teammates need him to, and Riyad Mahrez could even seal it here for City if he can find a shot. Konate with a tackle, but I don't think that's going to be enough time for the counter. Please, ref, no! We had the chances. We can't deny that we didn't. And what stands out is that 3v1? Where I tried to square it across for a simple tap-in, and the attacker found only the defender in the way. Oh, Everton desperately unlucky. It's 4-4 on aggregate there, and PSG go through on away goals as well. Unbelievable. Away goals needed in 3 of the 4 quarterfinals. Real Madrid through, Manchester City, Paris Saint-Germain and Inter Milan are into the semi-finals of the Champions League. We are out to the hands of Manchester City, unfortunately, so we will have to deal with that. And that means we can focus solely on La Liga moving forward. So it'll be Villarreal, Osasuna and Barcelona to end today, then Sevilla, Simeibar, play Bilbao and then decide what we do at the end of the season here, depending on the situation elsewhere in the league. But for now, we have to just lick our wounds, pick ourselves up and try and be ready for a cup final. I didn't want that to be. How is me saying we're stronger on paper a negative thing? That's odd. Right, Copa del Rey Cup Final. Where's it being played? At the Metropolitano. It's technically at home for the Cup Final. Let's go win some silverware, shall we? The eagle-eyed of you will have spotted, yes, it's a new day. I've changed clothes in between the last game and this one. We're at the Metropolitano, of course. It's weird to see it half and half with regards to the colour of the fans in the stands. Obviously, half red and white, half yellow for Villarreal here. Jonny Marulli in goal for Villarreal. They've got Paco Alcacer and Gerard Moreno up top again. 4-4-2 for them as per usual. And Chukwueze on the right-hand side's pace will be a real issue for us. I think we beat Villarreal in the league last time we played them, though. So we have to be confident that we can repeat that here. We are at full strength other than Akanji in alongside Konate for the tired Jose Maria Jimenez. He could still have an impact at a part to play off the bench, Jose Maria, but certainly not fit enough to start, or I wasn't happy to start him with as low with his fitness as low as it was. So we shall hope to still be able to get the job done defensively and offensively. It's as you would expect us to line up. Good footwork from Griezmann and Llorente, but not able to hold off the defender in the end. He's Retsos, centre-back. They've pushed players a long way forward there. Centre-back was well out of position, but what an interception by Morlanes. He was able to get back into that defensive line fairly quickly. That's a decent ball across, but we should be able to deal with that too. And everything Villarreal have questioned us with so far, we've dealt with. I'm not going to be able to find you properly with the pass there, I'm afraid. On the left-hand side there, Ferran Torres, but we can feed Griezmann in here. And Llorente, he could find and will find Ferran Torres. And we can deliver it towards the back post where Griezmann was waiting. It's a lovely clearance by Retsos. Ferran Torres trying to bring that down but can't. And the defence standing firm for Villarreal. They've been good so far. Chukwueze hasn't had the opportunity to race in behind. Now he does as Renan Lodi's drawn out of position. Akanji across to deal with it. Llorente, I see the run on the right, the left-hand side there, Ferran. Don't worry, I'm not ignoring you. I just didn't feel like it was the best option. Here's Correa now. Crossing, I don't feel, is going to be our strong point in this game. We don't have massively tall players. Yes, Joao Felix can score the occasional great header, but Marcos Llorente's right foot's pretty decent too. But Geronimo really makes the save, and it wasn't the most accomplished of defensive work there from the centre-back, but Felix's shot is blocked, and he can't quite get it under control at the second attempt. This is livening up now, this cup tie, 25 minutes in, but no opening goal as of yet. Gerard Moreno into Paco Alcacer. He's gotten away from Koke. Moreno has runners. One of which out wide here is Peña forward from right back, who's onside. He does have Chukwueze back there in support, and he's found him well. Into Morlanes. There's a number of red and white shirts in front of him, but somehow he's wriggled past all of them, and that is really poor from Jan Oblak. That's not what you expect from a keeper of his quality. That's not what we've come to expect from Jan Oblak. That was a tame shot and an awful save. He might as well have just picked up and thrown it in the back of his own net. That's how bad a save that was. He's literally pushed that straight to the Villarreal man. That's poor from the keeper. Gerard Moreno will not score an easier goal in his entire career, and we're 1-0 down in the cup final after half an hour, despite being the better team. Just can't find away past their defence. Try not to draw defenders too far out of position here, so as we allow them the way through. And oh, he's trying his hardest here, Ibrahima Konate, and he's done wonderfully well. And I'll lift this for João Félix, and we could be in behind. Knock it long and get away. Griezmann is arriving, but we might not be able to find him because there were too many people in the way. And Geronimo Rulli had a fairly comfortable save to make there. That'll fall free for Koke, and Marcos Llorente will come forward. João Félix, Griezmann will go to Llorente first. Out of his feet. Oh, it's well blocked by Retsos. Villarreal standing firm defensively, and we need to find a way through. 1-0 down at half-time. Ruben Peña. Great footwork from him. Morlanes. Paco Alcacer. Back to Morlanes again. He's got options. Well in. Manuel Akanji. And space for Griezmann to run into. Oh, but he's not as fast as he used to be. Throws himself to ground there in rather dramatic fashion. The referee does agree that it's a foul, but a little bit too far out to be able to do anything proper with. Kanzi's the obvious short pass, but then I didn't really have anything else available to me. That's Angel Correa here, I think. Indeed it is. Around the corner for Renan Lodi. Look at the gap through the middle there. For João Félix burst past the one defender, but can't get past the second. I'm going to need to make some changes, I think, if we're to get ourselves a piece of silverware here in this Copa del Rey final. Marcos Llorente into João Félix. Llorente's arriving. Llorente's arrived. Oh, but Geronimo really makes the save. Do we make any changes? Llorente is tiring. Quincy Promise is going to come on centrally. I don't care if he's not best suited to that position. I need the attacking intent. Up we go. That's a good header by Mukiele, but comfortable enough for Geronimo Rulli. We might actually just change Quincy Promise's position there. Moving forward to a cam if I can. There we go. That gives him some nice boosts to his rating rather than a minus one. And he's up to effectively an 86 rated player rather than down to an 80 rated player. And he might have a lot of work to do if we're not conceding a second team. Orlanes finds Gerard Moreno. That's better from Jan Oblak. A big save. A potentially tie-saving save. And from that, Ferran Torres is clean through in behind. Oh, but Chukwueze's with me! What a breakaway goal from Atletico Madrid in front of the travelling away fans. Technically, we should both be away fans, but it's at our home ground. So the half of the ground at the other end will go suitably berserk. We are level in the cup final. Lovely breakaway goal. Chukwueze very nearly got back to me. I had to make that turn away to the left-hand side just to keep the ball away from the winger. But it's a lovely finish on his left foot there from Ferran Torres, drilling it into the back of the net. We are level in the Copa del Rey final with 21 minutes to go. Sarachi. Moy Gomez just lofting it back. They've slowed things down here, Villarreal. They were pushing for that second goal, but now we've pegged them back. They've changed their approach again. They're just trying to take their time in the build-up to methodically pick us apart. It was a mistake from the goalkeeper that led to them getting their first goal. Hopefully, it's not pure genius from a man in yellow that leads to them getting a second. Here's Sarachi. I don't really know what sort of space to mark there with Koke. Nice tackle. Can we get to that? We have done. And on the breakaway, their methodical slow approach has drawn a number of players out of position. Where are you going, Angel? Oh, Quincy Promise is there. That's who that was intended for. That's who we'll find. Quincy Promise off the bench to maybe win us some silverware at Atletico Madrid. We lead by 2-1 in the 82nd minute. That's what I brought him off the bench to do. I wanted the extra attacking intent. Marcos Llorente is a good goal scorer, but Quincy Promise will be much more driven. And with those extra fresh legs and the boost in pace as well, that's exactly what we thought Quincy Promise could offer us moving forward. Initially, I was trying to hope he'd take it on his right foot. He took it on his left, but he's powered it into the back of the net. It's not featured much for us since coming in, Quincy Promise, but that is the role we brought him into play. Off the bench, have an impact, and ultimately, potentially, win us a trophy. Konate, he has been so solid. at centre-back, Ibrahima Konate. And the space is there for Correa. And we could finish this off now. Felix is there in the middle. I'll look to find him. Oh, they got lucky with theirs. We've gotten lucky with our third. We're going to win some silverware at Atletico Madrid. Driven cross really wasn't that good. Felix very nearly miscontrolled it wide, but he's just able to squeeze it home. That's a piece of silverware headed our way. We will win something in our single season at Atletico Madrid, and hopefully it's a sign of things to come in the Road to Glory style series that will start in a few days' time. Obviously, we have just a couple of episodes left of this series, and then Next Gen FIFA will be with us on December the 4th on Friday. And hopefully, I should, well, depending on when that's released, I should be able to get the first episode of the RTD out to you on that Friday. If I can't, then it will start on the Saturday. And I'm very much looking forward to that. I just, on autopilot, whilst doing a piece to camera, have skipped through the trophy lifting celebrations. Well done, cheese. Well done, mate. Atletico 3, Villarreal 1. We did lift some silverware. You just haven't seen it happen. Aye, aye, aye. Sorry, boys. Is this going to be a picture of it at least? Well, it's a picture of the press conference afterwards. Oh, that's such a Chez thing to do, isn't it? Get so engrossed in doing a commentary that I'm not really paying too much attention to what's going on with the game in the background. Right, Osasuna coming up next. The gap is still 6 points to Real Madrid. We could close that gap with victory here in this simulated game, which we should very well get. And we very well have not gotten. A 2-1 defeat to Osasuna as Real Madrid win 2-1 to Sevilla. That might be it. That might be it. Down to third we go, and the gap is up to 9 points with 6 games to go. And we have Barcelona next. Kostic is back from his injury, but he'll find it tough to feature between now and the end of the season. We'll just focus on our own performances here against Barcelona. It'll be tough for both teams, but we'll try and get victory over them as we did last time we played them. We're still in the fight for the title, but, well, my word, is it going to be difficult from here on out, I think. We shall continue to fight tooth and nail for every single point until it is mathematically impossible. Let's go and play at the Camp Nou. Let's get ourselves 3 points. Marc-Andre Ter Stegen in goal for Barcelona. Robertson, Longley, Alderweireld and Sergi Roberto as a back four. De Jong, Pereira and Guimaraes in the midfield with Dembele, Martial and still captaining the side on the right-hand side, Leo Messi for Barcelona, and still challenging for golden boots in this league, in this season, Leo Messi in season 4 of this save. Really, how he's still able to contribute as much as he is, I'm not sure. Obviously, physically, he must have really dropped off the wagon by now, Leo Messi, but still having the technical ability is enough for him to contribute massively to this Barcelona side's offensive efforts. Koke going to get away from the defender there, and it's a lovely run by Angel Correa, and he's in behind Clement Longley, and we could be in to lead early and well, an emphatic finish. That's how you fire back from losing to Osasuna at home. You take the lead at the Camp Nou after 6 minutes. Messi still got the pace to get away from Ferran Torres. Bruno Guimaraes. Messi quickly to Anthony Martial. Scored the last minute winner in the league game against us earlier on in the season. But we were able to get the better of them in the Copa del Rey semi-finals. Joao Felix looking for Ferran Torres. Oh, and he's won the header. Sergio Roberto didn't even challenge for it. 2-0 in the 14th minute away from home at Barcelona. That's almost unheard of. I want to have a look at that again. Sergio Roberto, he tracks the run well. And then just, he did go for it. He just couldn't get there. It's a wonderful header from Ferran Torres. And his 14th goal, sorry, his 8th goal of the La Liga season. No, yeah, his 14th goal. No, it was 14th minute, sorry. 8th goal of the season in the 14th minute for the number 8. I got all confused there. and we have ourselves a 2-0 lead. This would take us above Barcelona again in the league and with a game in hand. I don't know who Real have on this match day, but we're certainly doing our bit now. I can't believe we lost to Osasuna. I'm really, really, really frustrated at that. Nice tackle by Mukiele. Martial trying to keep the move alive. Bruno Guimaraes looking to build again, but Jose Maria Jimenez steps in. I don't even know where Javi is coming from. I don't have a player that has Javi in his name. I'm all over the place, aren't I? And Ferran Torres could be in here if he's onside, which he is. What's happening, Barcelona? What is actually happening? I thought he was off, genuinely, but you play to the whistle. I still think he's off after seeing that replay. What's happened, lads? We're 3-0 up inside 25 minutes away at Barca. I'm not sure what's happening here. Frenkie de Jong. Out to Andy Robertson. Clement Longley. Barcelona finally having a little spell of possession. They've done a lot of chasing the ball in the opening half an hour and watching it come back out of their net again towards the halfway line for another kickoff. Frenkie de Jong out-muscled by Joao Felix. And, well, they tried to keep the ball and they couldn't. Griezmann, space again. Fanghill Correa on his right-hand side. I see the man just there. It's Marcos Llorente we're going to drop it to. Ferran Torres on a hat-trick now. Joao Felix, well, they've backed off. If it weren't for Ter Stegen tipping that over the bar, we'd have been 4-0 up in the first half. He's come for that. Oh, and he's held it well. That's great goalkeeping. Finally, he actually does something worthwhile, Marc-Andre Ter Stegen. Basically no chance with any of the goals. And now he actually has the opportunity to save something. He's done that well. A change for Barcelona here. Matías Pereira coming off and Leon Goretzka coming on. You would have thought that Goretzka would have started. I'm not sure how much Matías Pereira has grown in this save, so I'm not gonna say he's certainly not worthy of that first team spot, but it was a surprise to see him there. Lodi will deliver this, and Griezmann on the volley! Oh, what a fourth that would have been. That would have been a wonderful goal. The Di Canio-style volley just past the post. Oh, what a ball by Messi to Sergio Roberto. That's a hell of a ping, looking to make up for his mistake that led to us scoring a goal earlier on. He's not able to do so. Ay, 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 Jose Maria, what was that? Could quite easily have played Ferran Torres in behind there. Messi's coming off, not lasting the full 90, just over an hour, and he's gutted to come off. You can see him there, hands behind his head. He's devastated to be leaving the field of play. Trincão was on in his place, the young Portuguese, but I was surprised to see them take Messi off, although, again, as we mentioned earlier, I guess his physical stats really have dropped off by this point in a save. And whilst technically he's still superb, I don't imagine his stamina is that good at this stage of a save. Martial trying to cause us problems up top. It's a lovely little roll of the defender. Did that take a deflection off Konate? It didn't. It's going to go out for a goal kick. And Barca have offered very little going forward in this game so far. And without Leo Messi on the field, they're going to offer even less, you'd imagine. Martial, we've been able to keep quiet so far in this game. That was the most dangerous he's been throughout the course of the game so far. Felix will lift this. And again, Sergio Roberto's out of position. Ferran Torres is on a hat-trick, so you can't deny him the chance of trying to seal it. But I can't get the ball across to him. Whip this looking for Felix. Again, the keeper has come to get to it. Marcos Llorente will recover this. Where are you, Ferran? Where is he? It's Jose Maria Jimenez. Oh, is that him there? Oh, Ferran Torres, you're not going to run all the way through from there. I'd love to get him a hat-trick, but he's just not going to have the chance to, is it? Llorente looking for Griezmann. He's gotten a little bit lucky, but it's going to squirm away from him and he can't get there. 12 minutes to go, still 3-0. Marcos Llorente into Griezmann. We could still seal it with a fourth, as if it isn't already sealed. You know, put a bit of gloss on the tie. Ferran Torres played in. He's not really going to get the chance to shoot from there. Or could he, you know? Or could he, you know? I don't quite know how he's done that, but Ferran Torres seals a hat-trick. How is that? I'm going to need to see a replay, I think. Ferran Torres makes it 4 and 3 for himself. He'll take home the match day from the Camp Nou here today. I tried to just do a fake shot there and, well, Ter Stegen has gone to slide and take it away from him and Ferran Torres has just run through it. I mean, you can see how high, how happy my in-game manager character is for Ferran Torres to score his hat-trick. Three of the best! He's made them pay, and with one of the last kicks of the game in the last few moments, we will seal a 4-0 win against Barcelona away from home. That's pretty remarkable. Hat-trick for Ferran Torres. GG, my man. Whether he earned that or not, I'm not sure. It was a little bit fluky to get the third, but we certainly earned that victory. Barca offered nothing in that game. I don't know what the situation was with them. That was a really peculiar match day. Unfortunately, that defeat to Osasuna leaves us 9 points behind with 15 points available. It is a tough ask. A very tough ask to see us beat Real Madrid to this league title. But you never know. We will start tomorrow with Sevilla. And then it's Eibar, Bilbao, Malaga and Granada to end the season. We'll probably end the season in tomorrow's episode. It will be a season finale. Do join me for it. Hopefully we can close that gap, but it would be one of the biggest turnarounds, I think, in La Liga history with a 9-point deficit with 5 games to go. Stranger things have happened. We shall wait and see. Drop the video a like if you enjoyed. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. There is not long to go now at all. Just a couple of days until next gen FIFA 21. Very excited for that. Join me on stream tomorrow for the start of the Cambridge United Football Manager save as well. I'll mention that again at the beginning of tomorrow's episode. But for now, that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.